Welcome to the Week in Review, the show that brings you up to date on the week that was. Here are the top stories. Bharti Airtel reports sharp drop in profits. Mumbai's airport revamp could cost more than double the original estimate. And commercial bids open for India's next combat aircraft. We begin with Bharti Airtel. India's largest phone company reported its steepest ever drop in earnings on Friday. The firm's second quarter net profit plunged 38% to 1,027 crores. That was on a revenue increase of 13% to 17,270. Broken up, that's an 11.7% rise in South Asia and a 22.9% increase in Africa. Airtel has now reported drops in profit for a seventh quarter in a row. But the company said some one-time losses contributed to the poor numbers. These include 240 crores worth of forex losses from Africa and a net interest cost of 115 crores. And staying with the industry, voice calls on your mobile phones could become free in a few years. Telecom regulator TRAI has recommended eliminating the charge for switching a call from one operator's network to another. This so-called interconnection tariff currently stands at 20 paise per minute. TRAI made its recommendation to the Supreme Court following a dispute among operators. Large operators with extensive networks want the interconnection fee to be high, but smaller telcos stand to benefit from lower tariffs. In other news, troubled firm SKS Microfinance is finally on its way to getting more capital. The company's board has approved a sale of shares to institutional investors through a so-called QIP process. The shares issue is slated to be worth 900 crores. What's more, the SKS board has also increased the authorized share capital to 1,350 crores from 950. SKS and other micro-lenders were battered last year after an Andhra law severely cut into their ability to recover payments from borrowers. Banks in turn stopped lending to MFIs. Since then, SKS has reduced the significance of its Andhra portfolio, which now accounts for barely 20% of its loan book, compared to around 26% at the time the law was passed. Another big earnings reported during the week came from the country's biggest private lender. ICICI Bank posted robust result that was supported by growing demand. Consolidated net profit rose 43% to 1,992 crores. That came along with a loan book that expanded 20% to 2.33 trillion rupees. CEO Chanda Kochar said loans from companies grew during the second quarter, but she admitted growth in retail loans had slowed down. ICICI Bank also benefited from a surge in profits from its life insurance business to 350 crores. Meanwhile, Wipro and Cognizant, the two big competitors in the IT industry, reported their earnings during the week. And though both firms posted profits, Cognizant was the better performer. Wipro's profits increased 1% to $265 million compared to the same period last year. That was on a revenue gain of 18% from IT services. Its operating margin went down 20% in the second quarter compared to 22% in the first. And US-based Cognizant beat both street estimates and Wipro. Profits grew 9.2% sequentially to $227 million and revenue went up 7.8% to $1.6 billion. That came along with an operating margin of 19.8%. Both Wipro and Cognizant expect the revenues in the next quarter to hover at around $1.5 billion. Switching to aviation, Mumbai's revamped airport could end up costing a lot more than previously estimated. The airport's main operator, GVK, revised estimates for modernization to 12,300 crores from the earlier 9,800. The initial estimate for modernization back in 2006 was less than 6,000 crores. The project to revamp Mumbai's cramped airport facilities has been plagued by time and cost overruns. Delhi's airport has also gone through cost overruns of its own with a current price tag of 12,700 crores. Operators typically transfer some of the higher cost to passengers by charging higher user fees. And here are some stories in brief. The Supreme Court has granted bail to Satyam founder B. Ramalinga Raju. Raju is the main accused in the Satyam accounting scandal. The court also gave bail to his brother B. Ramaraju and the company's then CFO Vadlamani Srinivas. The three men have been in prison for 2 years and 8 months. Meanwhile, DMK leader Kanimori and seven others have been denied bail in the 2G Spectrum case. A special judge turned down their bail pleas, calling the charges against them serious. Kanimori has now been behind bars for 5 months. India has started commercial bids for its mega deal to buy combat aircraft. The MMRCA contract is for 126 multi-role planes for the Indian Air Force and it could be worth more than $10 billion. The two shortlisted candidates are Dassault's Rafale and the Eurofighter Typhoon. PepsiCo CEO Indra Nooyi says her company plans to get half its revenue from developing countries in the next 5 years. Speaking at the Ad Asia Conclave in Delhi, she said she would ideally want 60% of the revenues from emerging markets, but would settle for 50%. And finally, the world is getting crowded. The UN estimates that there are 7 billion people in the world today. It symbolically set Monday, the 31st of October, as the day the world's population hit that mark. Of course, it's hard to keep an exact count with 2 babies being born every second. And that's all we have for you. Thanks for watching.